Hey, what's going on, you guys? I wanted to give you some kind of unfiltered feedback on IT-212 intro to computer networks. We will start off with the grades, but I kind of want to give you a bit of background in case this is your first time ever running into one of my videos. My name is Giovanni. I am a sophomore at Southern New Hampshire University Online. I work full time, and why you should be listening to me is because I have maintained an A and been on the honor roll for quite some time in regards to Southern New Hampshire University and worked full time throughout that. So if you are a working mom or a working dad full time, I'm talking like 30 to 40 hours or more a week, and you're considering if you should go to SNHU, maybe consider subscribing to my channel as I kind of document my process through this. So what we normally do is we go through the grades first. And I usually show those because some people don't believe when you're looking at this, you know, and you say, hey, I've been on an honor roll and, you know, I'm getting an A in the class. I usually kind of go through those things. So this class is done, and I want to give you some highlights of some things throughout this course that I think if you focus your time in on, will be well spent. So first of all, let's kind of block these into different parts here. So the first part, we're just kind of talking about what we'll call as module one. I just call them sections, but you may actually just feel like they are more better suited in the word module. So in the first module, one of the things that I noticed in this course, so make sure that you pay attention to this, is test out. So if you've never dealt with test out is a software, and I'll give you guys kind of a bird's eye view of test out. Now, this is what test out looks like. And what it does is it is, as it says on the screen, a premier IT training. And so they have different types of trainings, CompTIA-based, Cisco-based, those types of things. And what they're doing is preparing you for certification exams. And in this case for class, what I'm gonna do is log into the coursework for class. So I have my own private one, and then I have one specifically for school. And so they have used this in two classes that I've taken, the TestOut PC Pro, okay, and the TestOut Networking Pro. So what this does is this prepares you, as some people who are going on this journey as well, Networking Plus. So this would prepare you to take the Net Plus exam. This would also prepare you to take something called TestOut Networking Pro. And why this is important for you is because in this particular class, let's say that you have a TestOut you have the TestOut Network Pro certification, like you pass their test. So what TestOut, let me back up a second so that at least this part will make sense to you, why the TestOut certificates matter, is because what TestOut says is that if you can pass their test, then you could go to employer saying, I know what I'm doing. Not that I just memorized questions and did some practical work. This is you had to do the practical work in order to pass the exam. So that's what they kind of vouch off of. And in this case, I think it's really important for you to know that part, because this exam here will cost you about $150. So get ready in class to pay for this. And why that matters was because in this first portion, I did not have the money at the time to pay for the course. I mean, to pay for the test out course. So I let that go. It went through the first week, never did the work for the test out quiz. And I had an F here. Now I had an A in the discussion, but an F here. So I say that to mean, of course, with SNHU, you have a week to submit the previous work. So the next week when I got paid, I went through and I paid for my test out voucher so that I could get this particular class. And so don't worry about if you can't afford the $150 or whatever it is in your particular currency, since I have new followers from different countries, then I want to make sure, you know, hey, don't worry about that part. Just get the test out part. You will need that. Next. The second week, where in here you need to pay attention to the discussion part inside of here, the IT interview. I do think you need to go a little bit in depth into the IT interview questions. And so the rubric for this is not as huge as you may think. but I just want you to know what's going on. Don't worry about the discussion post as much as you do what you actually ask in your questions, because that's really what he's looking for. When you get to module three, this milestone right here, okay, this milestone here is an increasingly overlooked milestone, because here you're going to find out what exactly, and I'll get to three, because I think three was something that at the time I was like, oh, this is going to be pretty easy to do. It wasn't. I'll get to the milestone one and kind of explain where you need to be and what you need to look at. So in three, this is the scenario, okay? And if you're a person who's putting this scenario into like an AI system, for example, and you're trying to figure out how to go through and have the AI spit out some things, you can reach out to me directly. I am not on Instagram as much as I used to be, and that's where a lot of you have been writing to me. You can email me. I'll put my email inside of the show notes for this, but I do think that if you email me, I've written to people, or if you just respond in this video, I've worked with people directly to help them. But in this whole scenario, the parts that you really need to focus on, okay, these key considerations. So go through, hit key considerations. So when you're writing, write key considerations. When he's asking about land topology, break your paper down into this. Reason why is because if you look, this is how he's grading it. So he's going to look for key considerations. If you want exemplary, you have to be able to break these down for him. Another thing that's not noted here, but is noted here. 1 to 2 pages in Word, double spaced, 12 point. Where I've seen people go wrong with this is they miss these other points. It's APA style, which means you need to have references or put some references in there, and it needs to be 12 point. I've seen people write this paper and then completely omit this part. They focus in on everything up here, but miss that part. So that is a key part, because when you get ready to go back, all right, to the next assignment that I think you really, you know, I think is kind of important, is when you get to your milestone two. Because now in your milestone two, there's a lot to break down, okay? And this milestone two is when you get ready to do this network design. So I'll tell you areas to doing your paper. Same thing, follow. Who is the internet service provider? Answer these questions based off of the scenario he gave you in one. Additional configurations, answer the questions. Do your network design. If you are not good in network design, there is a very, like, Google Documents has a built-in way for you to do like circles and squares and things like that. That's how I did my topography, okay? They do give you some options here that you can use. If you're a Visio fan, that's great. Again, remember, it's APA format, 1 to 2 pages. Make sure your points are good. Break your paper down in here, just like this. You'll do well. Just follow exactly what he gives you here. You'll be fine. Now, the final paper. The final paper is quite long. And we'll start with the number of pages first. Okay? 3 to 5 pages. So this is not some small thing. But you have done most of the work already. Remember, we did key considerations in one. We did land topology in two. Internet service providers was in three. So you're going to do your internet service provider, hardware, printer, and bandwidth. Just break the paper down, answer the questions that he asked, break it down into these sections, and then submit your paper. My paper that I submitted was 6 pages long. So that was outside of and in excess to what he had. So don't worry yourself about that, okay? So those are the only things throughout this course that I think are major. I don't think that any of the other stuff, if you've taken any of the courses, and by the time you take this course anyway, you've had another previous course that would prepare you for this. None of this is else, you know, exceptional that's going to be something big. Focus on your milestones. You will be successful. If you have any other questions or this has been beneficial to you and understanding how to prepare for IT-212, by all means, please drop me a like on this video. Consider subscribing if that's something that you want to do. And additionally, make sure that you leave a comment, or at least if there's questions that you have, just leave a comment and I'll be happy to go through and answer those questions inside of the comments. And that makes it for everybody who comes to the video. They have the answers. If it's something privately you want to talk to me about, I am on Twitter. You can look my name up on Twitter. You can find me on Instagram. I'm not there as much in DMs. I am inside of TikTok a lot more. So if you find me on TikTok, I'll be happy, you know, absolutely, you can reach out to me there. I am going to go ahead and let you guys go. I appreciate you coming to check out my video. Again, if anything has been beneficial, consider subscribing, and I'll talk to you later.